after, because I stopped playing music for 4 years. When I moved to Italy, yeah, I stopped, because I used to play in a band before ADF, and I did that for 10 years.
Wow.
And then I had enough. I just wanted a normal life.
What was it about the band that...
it was a band called King Prawn.
What was it about that made music. You want to stop?
It just the band had run its course really. Yeah. Like 10 years, most of that on the road.
Yeah.
We'd done, I think, 4 albums or so with that band and taken it as far as we could.
Yeah.
Without any record company, without any support. Really. We did it. Everything was, it was DIY really.
How did you distribute music?
It was a small independent.
Yeah.
It was an independent
label
in the UK that we had. But we didn't have no support. I mean, it was crazy, some of the stuff we were doing. We were going out and playing, like doing TV, like prime time TV performances.
Mm.
And not in England, abroad.
Mm-hmm.
But you couldn't buy the record in the shop. So it was a complete waste of time. That's what I'm saying. There's no backing. Nothing was coordinated.
Didn't they look to bring some CDs over while you're over? Or, no. You know, like 100 copies or something?
No. Well, I thought that I would hope that they brought more than 100.
Well, you know, it's better than zero, right?
No, I suppose so. It just got to a stage where I think also after playing with people. It's nothing personal against the people that you play with in the band, but like, when you've been playing for like 7 or 8 years on the road,
you get to know each other too well, don't you?
Yeah, too well, there's that person, every time you open your eyes, they're always there, the only time you can get away from them is when you close your eyes, when you sleep, but everyone's always there, sort of thing, and it's just that, it's that cabin fever, isn't it? Sort of sets in after a while, and just getting on everyone's nerves. Nothing personal.
Didn't you think about doing some other projects at the same time?
No, because it was like I said, the band we used to do everything ourselves,
Your time was totally summed up, wasn't it?
Exactly. Between being on the road, having to deal with just
press.
Having to do it yourself. Not even press. Like designing the. Things that usually that label, your record company do for you, you have to do yourself, sort of thing. And but after, like I said, but basically after 10 years of race course, and, I already decided to move to Italy.
Yeah.
And that was sort of like the final nail in the coffin, I think, for the other guys in the band.
Do they continue still today, the rest?
Yeah.
Successful? Are they doing well?
I think most of the projects they've just started.
Mm.
Still in the early stages, what they're doing.
Yeah.
But I basically moved to Italy. I had no intention of playing music again. Didn't even really think about it. I was quite happy to be at home after spending so many years not on the road. And because the thing is that when you play in a band and you're always on the road, you lose contact with reality, especially your friends. I was going back and I was finding.
Didn't know anybody anymore.
Yeah, I had very little in common. Because they're all off working.
Yeah.
At that age, they were starting to have families and things, and you're just like doing what, just like traveling around, playing shows night after night.
Yeah.
And when I'm out with my friends, didn't have much to say to them,
It's a tough experience, really. Actually, being in a band, people don't realise that.
Yeah, and it's also quite lonely being in the band, as well.
Mm.
It can be quite a lonely experience. And I just had enough of all of that sort of lifestyle. The lifestyle, I just wanted to have something. I just wanted a taste of normality, really.
More stable.
It wasn't even a question of stability. It's just like, if you're in a band and you're trying to write stuff, but you're not really in contact with reality, what do you write about?
You can dream.
Yeah.
How did you come together with
ADF?
ADF.
Like I said, I moved out to Italy in 2003. Not really. I went out there to teach, actually. I was working teaching there. And then in 2007, at the beginning of 2007, I can't remember if it was an email or phone call from Steve. I didn't really know Steve.
Mm.
I met him a couple of times.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, do you want to do a song on the on Punkera, which is the last the album which has just been released now.
Mm-hmm.
I said, yeah, okay, just send me the stuff, and he sent me this thing. I think it was something that he did. He'd been working on the opera, or the Gaddafi opera, and it was something that was left over that he liked.
Mm-hmm.
And so he sent it to me, and then I just penned a verse, let's say, and then he came and we worked on it in Italy a bit, and then he was asking me about another song for the album. I went, okay, I'm not doing anything. Then he told me that they were looking for a live singer, someone to come live.
Mm-hmm.
And this was just before the summer of 2007. So I wasn't doing anything because my school was closed for the holidays.
Mm.
And I said, okay, I'll come do these shows with you. Just thinking, it was just, you know, I wasn't thinking to be in the band or anything like that. I thought it was just, you know, and then because I didn't understand what was going on with the old singer and the politics involved and everything.
Mm.
And then I just fell into it. Just did a few shows, and then I just went and did the album with them.
Mm-hmm.
Just been doing it since.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Just luck. They came knocking on my door.
That's luck. A lot of people would like.
I mean,
to hear that.
I've met Steve a few years before. They asked me to do. I can't remember. I don't know what album it was, but when I was in my old band, he asked me to if I wanted to do a song, an ADO song. But I just didn't have time to do it. In fact, it turned out to be the song Lahaine, an ADF track, and I just didn't have time to get around to doing it, and sort of never thought anything of it really. And then he liked what I did with my old band, and just
clicked.
Yeah. He just said that because he heard that. They were looking for a new single. I wasn't doing anything, but I live in Italy. That was just
a bit of a distance.
You know? But they said it wasn't a problem for them.
Mm.
You know, which is alright.
And politically, I mean, it's such a political band.
I don't think we all bang the same drum.
I don't think you could.
No, we're all from different. Backgrounds. We're all from different backgrounds. I think we're all individuals. We don't all bang the same drum. As to say that we don't come from a particular political ideology. We're not Labour supporters. We're not from the right. We're not from the left. You know, can't put your finger. But you know, what unites us is the music.
Mm.
And the way that we do it, because you could say it's a political band. I don't know if you say political, it's sort of to me it suggests sort of being of a particular ideology, but we're not.
Yeah.
You know, and I think that what we do is more like a social commentary. You know, and it's not. They're not the only band. ADF's not the only band to be doing.
There are not very many.
No, I think there are a lot of people who do making sort of, you know, conscious music with conscious lyrics, you know. We're not singing love songs here,
no.
You know. But who's to say in the future that won't happen, you know?
Mm.
You can't rule anything out.
Yeah.
But
when you're about 65?
So when you're young, isn't it? Yeah, sort of young and angry. When you're older, you're old and bitter.
Yeah. And then you get lovely.
There's one scene I can't dimension creeps in. Yeah. Everything's fluffy.
Exactly.
I think that what sets ADF apart is the way that they do it musically.
Mm.
That's the thing that makes it different.
Quite an original sound.
Exactly,
isn't it?
Yeah, and that's what makes them stand out from the rest.
Yeah.
And like, you know, you could say, like I said before, they're not the only band. We're not the only band to be doing it. And I think that one band on its own is like, I don't know, it's almost like, it's not going to make a big difference, you know? Let's be realistic. But when you have a thousand, 10,000 people shouting with the same voice, then that can make a difference.
Music
can make a difference. It can be more than just listening to, you know, the sounds that come out of the speakers of your hi-fi, you know, listen to radio. It has the power to change people's lives, you know, and it changed mine.